It's 8:35, and providing you haven't got children looking over your shoulder, some of you will have now gone to lbc.co.uk to see the video of a 15-year-old American cousin of a Palestinian teen who was abducted and killed in Jerusalem, himself being beaten and jailed by Israeli police in what relatives are calling an attempted murder. It really is a shocking video. Tariq Khadir, a student at the Universal Academy of Florida, an Islamic school in Tampa, is the cousin of Muhammad Abu Khadir, who, it's claimed, was burnt to death by Israeli extremists in a revenge attack on Wednesday. That was for the death of those three teens, of course. The deaths, I should say, of those three teens. Now, Tariq's parents, Suha and Salah, told the Associated Press their son was beaten by police during clashes on Thursday ahead of the funeral and that he was detained. Israeli police are saying that Tariq had resisted arrest and attacked police officers. Well, if you look at the video, even if he was stupid enough to attack police officers, which I'm not condoning, the level at which they go after him is absolutely shocking. Jonathan Sacerdoti is director of the Institute for Middle East Democracy and joins me now. Where do we go next with this story, Mr. Sacerdoti?
Morning, Nick. Yes, it's horrific to see the escalation in tensions in Israel, absolutely, at the moment. And as we're remembering the 7/7 bombings today on the 9th anniversary here in London, it's worth remembering that we've never known in the UK the level of terrorism on a scale that they suffered in Israel. The Israeli civilians have been suffering for decades. And that is what makes it so scary, seeing these sorts of things going on right now. And I think it's particularly scary for Israeli civilians. Just to bring you up to date with the latest developments in the region, over the last few hours. Over the course of last night, there were Palestinian rocket attacks on southern Israel, 7:02, 2:56 a.m., 2:31 a.m., 2:15 a.m., 1:51 a.m., 11:23 p.m., and 11:22 p.m. And the Palestinian Maan news agency reported that yesterday dozens of young Palestinians were throwing petrol bombs at the location of Joseph's tomb, a holy site for Jews. Last night, Israeli troops attacked positions in Gaza, hitting rocket launchers and other targets, and a terror tunnel collapsed, apparently unrelated to those, killing another eight terrorists. So things on the West Bank and things in Gaza are absolutely hotting up, and it's something that's making many civilians on both sides very afraid of what's coming next. You know, for a long time, since around late 2000s, people have been predicting a third intifada. I don't think that's about to happen, but what we're seeing now is the escalation in tension as a result of the end of the peace talks and the failure of those peace talks, and then the horrible events that have happened since then on both sides, the murder of the three Israeli teens, then the horrible murder of the Palestinian teen, and now this latest video that you're drawing attention to on the website. It's all quite brutal and quite horrific to watch, and the peoples on either side are obviously understandably afraid of what's going on.
The Israeli government, or some members of the Israeli government, blamed Hamas for the killing of those three Israeli teens. Has that now been confirmed?
So far, the Israeli government haven't revealed all of their intelligence, but usually, from my experience of watching things in the region, when they are so certain and they pin their intentions so firmly on specific people as well, not just Hamas, but they have specific people in mind.
They named two specifically, didn't they?
Yeah. Exactly, and recently a third, who they have actually now arrested in order to help with their investigations. I usually find that in the long haul, when we finally get shown the intelligence, if we do get shown it, often it's protected for operational reasons in the beginning. I mean, obviously, you can't reveal your entire hand when you're involved in an ongoing manhunt. Usually, I think they wouldn't pin their colors to the mast quite so firmly if they weren't certain themselves that that was what was behind this. And, you know, the people they're looking for who've been missing since the very day those teenagers who were shot in the car killed hitchhiking home from school, the people that they're looking for have been invisible since then. They've gone missing. Their own families don't know where they are since that very day. They're known Hamas operatives who've been associated with Hamas for a long time, and I suppose that's part of the reason why they're being held responsible, why Hamas is being held responsible for that action. And of course, if you look at these recent murders that have taken place, the three Israeli teenagers and the one Palestinian teenager, so far, six Jewish alleged extremists who are thought to have carried out or been involved with the killing of the Palestinian have been arrested within days. But over a month after the three Israelis were taken and shot, There has been no suitable arrest until just yesterday when this one man was arrested, and there are still the two main killers or suspected killers on the run. So it is clear that the Israeli authorities are taking seriously all of these horrific killings and trying very hard to bring to justice those who are behind the attacks.
Thanks for that. Just Jonathan Sasha.